welcome back to my channel. So today I'm coming at you with a little bit of a different video. It is Hubby Picks Out My Makeup. So I got this idea off of Jessica Braun here on YouTube. I absolutely love watching her. And her husband Tyler comes on her channel quite a bit. He has his own channel too. I think it's Tyler Travels, I think. It's a vlog. But anyway, I love the couple. They're just absolutely super sweet. And so anyway, I saw Tyler pick out Jessica's makeup. And it was super, super sweet. So I was like, I wonder if my hubby will do that for me. So Eric, my husband, kindly obliged me and picked out a full face of makeup for me. I have to preface by saying, though, that he knows absolutely nothing about makeup. And bless his heart, he just, like, I told him stuff before. And it's, I mean, it just... it kind of flies over his head kind of thing. So, but yeah, so I'll go ahead, and show you what all he picked out. I want to preface also by saying that he did not want to be on camera, have his face shown on camera. And I need you guys to, respect that and understand that, please, just because he's in the military and we just don't want to put that out there. So he just kindly asked that I not show his face on camera. And so of course I obliged, and I said, like, course, you know, not a big deal to me. So thank you guys ahead of time for understanding that he did not want to be on camera, but you will see his hands and he will make a couple comments and be a little silly as he is. We're both a very silly couple, both very silly people and silly as a couple. So yeah, we're just like big goofballs. So the drawer that I was going to open got stuck, so you're gonna see me struggle with that for a minute and then kind of jump back in there. And so yeah, so it's not the best like filming and all that, but he was so, so kind to do that for me. So thanks, babe, I love you if you ever watch this video. But so yeah, so we'll go ahead and get into it. I had to say, the stuff that he picked out I'm actually kind of excited about. So we'll go ahead and jump to him picking my stuff out, and then I'll come back on and I will go ahead and get started with my full face of makeup that my hubby picked out. All right, hey guys, Eric's gonna pick out my makeup. He knows nothing about makeup, right? Yep, he knows nothing, so. All right, go ahead and pick out a concealer from this portion. Okay, so he picked out the Maybelline Superstay Better Skin. Okay, and pick out a mascara from back there. Get. He picked out the Too Faced Better Than Sex Waterproof Mascara. Okay. Pick out a liquid eyeliner if you would. The liquid one, and it is. It is an old Ico liquid liner. So, okay. Cool beans, that's that drawer. All right, so from here, you're going to, hang on, pick out a blush on this side. Okay, he picked the Too Faced Baby Love. Okay, pick out a bronzer from the middle section. He picked the Too Faced Soleil Milk Chocolate. It's a good one. And pick out a highlighter. Okay, and he picked, ooh, Champagne Pop. That's a good one. Okay. Moving on down. Something is getting stuck and I don't know what it is. I think it's something from the drawer below it. Okay. Figured it out. Something got stuck. I fixed it. All right. Eyeshadow palette drawer. Go ahead and pick something from here. Not that one. Okay. This is the Too Faced Summer Limited Edition Summertime Palette. Okay. Pick something out of the face palette drawer. You want the Becca palette. Okay. And you're going to... okay, that's a good lippy. Pick a foundation. Is it my shade? It's not my shade. Pick another one. It's not my shade. It's too tan for me right now. It's too tan for me right now. Pick another one. Oh, he broke it. Stop. Pick another one. Okay. Instead, he's picked the Maybelline Dream BB Fresh. I think that is everything. Let me double check. Got a bronzer, blush, highlight, face, Oh, primer. You didn't pick a primer. Primer are in the back. There are these, so in these couple ones and then these back ones back here. That's foundation. Sorry. Yep, next to it, to the left, is the primers. What? I don't want to know. Alexa's not a primer. Nice. Good choice. Okay. Too Faced, Hangover RX. Okay. Scrub everything, eyeshadow palette. Duh, 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 duh. All right, that's it. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Hi, guys. We're doing our makeup with the stuff that my hubby picked out. And I'm super hungry. I apologize. You know those things are like, what are they, mukbangs, I think, or mukbang, I'm not sure how to pronounce them. But they're like all the thing nowadays. I actually hate watching people eat on camera. I don't know what it is, I can't stand the sounds, but I'm very sorry. If you're like me, I'm sorry. But I'm starving. Okay. We're fresh-faced. I'm gonna pull my hair back with the lovely cat ears, okay? Put my hair back there. All right. So I wash my face and everything. I have a mirror down right in front of me so I can see what I'm doing. And I have a wet sponge I prepared. Okay, so first thing that Eric picked out. I'm just going to go. Down in order how to do my face what he picked out. So the first thing that we had that he picked out is the Too Faced Hangover RX Primer. This is a brand new one, actually. This is a primer that I used to use all the time, but I haven't used in quite a long time, so I'm excited to get back into it because I know I used to really love it. Just gonna put it all over. This does feel quite nice and hydrating on the skin. I mean, obviously it's an RX primer, so probably some leftover chip on my face because I'm a messy eater. Yeah, so it's got coconut water, probiotic-based ingredients, skin reviver, silicone-free, and it does feel really nice, and I remember it had to kind of like have like a sticky, tacky feeling to the skin, just a little bit, not like terrible, but just enough to like I knew it was going to hold on to whatever I was going to put on top of it. Okay, it's a nice, refreshing primer. I remember that why I like that. It's a very nice feeling on the skin. Okay, so the foundation that he picked out was the Maybelline Dream BB Fresh in the shade 110 Light / Medium Sheer Tint. I got this recently because I can't remember if I saw a YouTuber wear it or something like that. I forget where. Anyways, I was just like, I used to love drugstore BB creams. And then I got out of them and started using stuff like Lancome. I'm sorry, I feel like I have to burp and those chips are not going down well. That's a little better. Anyway. I used to use, drugstore BB creams all the time, but then I kind of got into, like, the Lancome, and actually I'm going to pause for 2 seconds. I just put that on, but I need to put a little green color correcting on my spots. One thing he didn't pick out were my color correctors, because that's just something that I use, like, on the daily. So, if you don't know, the color green combats the color red, and it neutralizes. So if you have red hyperpigmentation, anything like that, green definitely corrects that and turns it into an even base for you to work on. So color correcting a little bit there. I'm going to go in with the salmon under my eyes too, just because my eyes are so dark. Anyway, okay, continuing on. Sometimes I apply this with my fingers, sometimes with sponge. We're going to do a sponge today just because that's just what I feel like. So I'm going to go with a little light layer first. I hope that music's not too loud in the background for you guys. I'm on the country kick right now. Okay. Just blending her out. I feel like sometimes, like, fingers are better about getting it more evenly dispersed on your skin. Like, especially when it comes to, like, BB creams. I don't know. I feel like sponges that often. Actually, you know what? I think what I'm going to do. Does that look a little too dark? I'm definitely going to blend it down the neck, though. It's for show. Oh, my gosh. You remember back in the day, guys, when, like, faux shizzle my nizzle was, like, the thing to say? Golly. I wish those days would come back. Those days were so great. I think I actually get a little more coverage like I'm wanting, yeah. See, some days I feel that fingers still work really well to apply things. And people are like, oh, fingers are unhygienic. Well, you know what? My hands are sanitized. You wanna know how I know? Because I sanitize them every 20 minutes. Why is that? Oh, yeah. Hashtag coronavirus. But no, my hands are clean. I don't ever touch my face without my hands being clean. Unless I'm out in public and I sneeze, or I got like a cough or something and I got a whole lot of hair through my face. Okay, I don't really like putting a whole lot on my forehead because I've got these like lines or whatever and I just don't feel like it accentuates them. So it's pretty good. I actually like that BB cream. Forgot what that looked like. It's definitely a sheer coverage. Although the concealer I'm going to put on will definitely help conceal more of those things. Alrighty. So now we're going to put on my pink tone corrector. Oh, itchy, excuse me. Okay. This is just the Urban Decay correcting fluid. And if you don't know, pink/salmon colors is what's going to balance out the blue tones, correct those, and turn those neutral. So that's what normal people's under eyes look like instead of mine. And I've got some people that have just been like, you know, have you tried to, do you take your makeup off thoroughly enough? And yes, I do, actually. I definitely tell you, like, take the time to take off my makeup. Same amount of time I do putting into doing my makeup. If you guys hear me, like, I'm going to my concealer, though. It's the Maybelline Better Skin, Super Stay Better Skin that he picked out for me in the shade 10 Ivory. But if you guys ever notice, I get tongue-tied quite a bit, and, I got tested in college, and I do actually have a bit of attention deficit, it's more ADD than it is ADHD because, I get so tongue-tied, and that's just because my brain is moving miles faster than my mouth can keep up with, and that's the reason why I also speak fast. I do try regularly to try to slow it down. But in college, though, I actually got tested. They're like, yeah, you actually do have, you are ADD, but you do have a bit of ADHD as well. Hence why I can multitask really well. If you give me I used to do all the time in elementary school. I used to do read 4 or 5 books at one time and keep all the storylines straight, which is quite difficult to do. But that was one thing I was just like, oh, yeah, I can do that. Not a problem. Like, I can keep up. School was super easy for me because I could keep up with it just really easily. So because of that, though, that's where the ADHD comes in, is I'm able to do that kind of stuff. Whereas ADD, I don't get quite as hyper from that. It's just more of a forgetfulness because my mind is off somewhere else. But I definitely do. Have it, but I don't take any medication for it. I just have kind of, I guess, dealt with it. Never really knew I had it until, like I said, I got in college, and I was like, I'm gonna get tested because I feel like I have it. And my I think my mom. Well, I'm pretty sure my mom has it, which is I think where I get it from. I think my brother's got a touch of it as well. So it definitely runs in our family. But so yeah, so if I ever get tongue-tied like that or I'm speaking fast, I do apologize. I do, when I get nervous or excited, I tend to talk really fast. So I do try to like slow myself down. That's always an issue that I've had. I've always had people be like, Kat, slow down. I'm like, I'm so sorry. It's just the way I am. Luckily, my husband has never ever told me to slow down my speech, and he always just has understood that I'm just a fast talker, and when I get excited, my words get ahead of me. So, or my brain gets ahead of my mouth, you know what I mean? Anyway, this concealer is nice. I used to use this all the time in high school, actually, until I, like, actually learned what other stuff was, though. I don't think it has the highest coverage, especially for somebody like me that really wants, like, a lot of full coverage. I'm just gonna put, I know I've done this twice, but I'm gonna put a teeny bit more just on those dark parts because I really want to try to conceal that. And back in high school, this, you know, I didn't really have as dark as circles. This stuff worked great for me. And I never color corrected or anything. It was just fine on its own. But looking back, though, I kind of had darker circles in high school, more so than I thought I did. I guess I just didn't really notice until I got later in life. But so that's that. He didn't pick out a powder for me. That's okay. I'm going to do one I'm just gonna, this is the first one that I just saw. It's the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder in 05 Fair. I'm just gonna do this one because why not? Grab my brush here. So this powder is new to me. Everybody on YouTube was raving about it, and I'd heard like all these people were just like, you've got to try this, like it's so good, like it just, it sets really pretty, and I actually do like it. You can actually see it gives me a bit more coverage, which I do like that. And yeah, so I finally caved, and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna see what I was talking about, and actually I don't wear this powder. So yeah, I have to make sure that I tuck this though into my crepey lines under my eyes, because I do have fine lines under my eyes. I do use retinol cream though under there to try to help those like correct, but I do get some crepiness, so that's actually not bad. Yeah, I'm fine. Make sure they're really in there. Okay, not bad. So that's what I use for under my eyes, and then to set my face, let me, if I can. Does anybody else have problems with packaging? There we go. Okay, so to set my face, let me go have him pick out a powder really quick, and then I will be right back. So 1 second. Okay, I just had him pick out a powder, and he came in and grabbed the first one that he saw. So yeah, he picked out the Fenty powder in the shade Butter. So here's the thing, he actually grabbed this Fenty powder, which is in the shade Lavender, but because it's super bright and not for, it's for like under eye stuff, I told him, I was like, that's under eye, and I already set my under eye because I picked one. So he picked Butter. It's just right next to it in the drawer. So we're gonna go ahead and set my face. I do like this powder, it's very lightweight, but it does mattify pretty well. I'm actually gonna use a more sparsely packed brush, just because this is probably gonna really mattify it down for me. Yeah, gonna make my skin look really smooth. I don't mind mattifying powders. I prefer most definitely like a looser powder. Or not looser, what am I saying? See, there we go, I'm doing something and now I'm my mind is going off somewhere else. I prefer a more hydrating and luminous powder just because of my dry skin. Just gonna make sure that my forehead lines are nice and smoothed out before I apply the powder to set it in there. Okay. But yeah, I definitely prefer a more luminous powder. Just to help me give that glow. I do love glow all year round, but yeah. So it's actually looking nice. My pores, it is pretty smooth, and it definitely does make me just look very smooth, poreless, I guess. That powder is actually really nice. I really do like it. I do like setting my under eyes with it as well, but particularly the lavender because it mega brightens up my under eye. So you love that. But so yeah, so that's that so far. There we go. Okay, next up, he picked this bronzer, which is the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil bronzer, which is really nice. It is just a matte bronzer. I do really like this. It's very light. I had him pick out a face palette as well because it had different options in it. So for this face palette, I picked out the Becca Apri Ski Glow. Is that right? Apri Ski, yeah, Glow Face Palette. So this bronzer in here is the shade Pre Coast, I believe. It's not, it's Bronze Bondi, which is actually a little bit deeper. So milk chocolate and Bronze Bondi. So that's the milk chocolate and that's the Bronze Bondi. Definitely a cool to warm. I think I'm just gonna stick with the milk chocolate because I do like it. We're gonna grab a giant fluffy brush to do this with. I'm just gonna dip into there, tap. I do like this bronzer. It is very nice. This is the very first bronzer that I ever had. Ooh, I just got to inhale the powder and it definitely tastes like chocolate. It's quite nice. Just gonna use a leftover to bronze up the forehead a little bit, hit those temples. Mm-hmm. A candle back there, by the way, is a Victoria's Secret candle. It's called Coconut and Palm Leaves, and it's very tropical. And I thought it was very appropriate for upcoming summer. I want it to be summer already. If you've ever been in Europe, I guess, period, in the summertime, or in England, they don't really do air conditioning, so it gets a little hot here. And being from Tennessee, which I don't know if I've ever said that, guys, I'm from Tennessee. I'm from Memphis originally, home of rock and roll and the blues. But I'm from Memphis, and it can get real hot real quick there in the summertime. But I do love it, but I've always been able to handle it because we have air conditioning in the States, but they don't have it here, and sometimes, y'all, I die because it's pretty hot. You wouldn't think it would because it's England, but it does. And if I could find the brush I'm looking for, that'd be peachy. I really would appreciate the brush disappearing at the moment. There she is. Got it. Okay. So that's the bronzer. Pretty nice. I like it. A great choice for a bronzer, so there is that. All right, next up for blush, he picked the Too Faced Love Flush blush in the shade Baby Love. They're discontinuing these, I believe, so if you can definitely, they're on sale, so I would most definitely get your hands on them if you want them. They last all day. I really do like this blush formula. If I got Keith Urban playing in the background, I hope you can't hear it, because what is that, a thing, like, if, like, YouTube sees that you're, like, is it copyright? Is that it? Definitely giving credit. That's Keith Urban in the background if you can hear it. Definitely not trying to rip him off or anything. It's really pretty blush. I'm trying to lightly do it. I love this brush to apply it. This is the Jaclyn Hill Morphe Collection JH06 brush. I love it because it's just so, like, see how bendy that is? It just, like, gently sweeps it all back, and it's gorgeous. So that's super pretty. It's a matte blush with, like, a teeny bit of shimmer to it, and I think I want to add, I don't know if I want to add anything from this palette or not. I don't know if this is too pink and I'll clash with it. I think this is, like, Winterberry or something. That's got a little bit of sheen to it, I think. Maybe you want to go in with, see, that's a highlighter. Maybe if I can tap this highlighter a little bit over my cheeks, it might give me that kind of luminous. Yeah, that's doing a little bit better. It's giving me that more luminous over the cheeks, which I prefer. So that's actually the, I'm using this. It's the Rose Quartz highlighter. I'm using that, just taking it again on this brush, kind of giving it a little tap off, and then just kind of coming over the cheeks. And it's giving me that little bit of luminosity that I really like. So, yeah. That actually works out pretty well. I like that. Cool beans. Okay, so for highlighter, he picked out, I didn't know what he was going to pick out at first, but then he, like, just up and grabbed it. And it's the Becca highlighter in the shade Champagne Pop. It's the collab that Jaclyn Hill did with Becca forever ago, but they made it permanent shade because it was so good. But he picked it out for me unknowingly that it's my favorite. Oh, it's so pretty. It's definitely one of my favorite highlighters ever, ever, ever. A really pretty peachy pinky kind of. Oh, it's just gorgeous. Okay. I always like to get it on the tip tops of my cheek right here. I do have a little bit of texture, but I do do some acid peels and stuff too to try to help with that, like, combat the texture, because I like wearing my highlighter here, you know, like this kind of shiny cheeks. Bring it on the bridge of the nose, hit the tip, my cupid's bow just a little bit, and then the little bit on the chin. It's a little too much. And so, yeah, so that's pretty much my base done. I think you did a good job picking those products out. Yeah, really like that. I think it's pretty. Okay, so for eyes, he picked out the this is the Tarte Be a Mermaid and Make Waves palette. This is the limited edition palette that came out, I think, almost three summers ago. It's a really pretty palette. I really do enjoy this. Let me see. I'm going to grab my cup here. It's got all my brushes in it. And if I can find, there it is, my color switch. Got my color switch because I don't clean my brushes as often enough as I should. So I'm just taking the Anastasia Beverly Hills A10 blending brush, and we're going to dip into the shade Sandbar right here first. I was going to try some blues, but I think I don't really want to do blues today. But we're just going to pop that in the crease. Oh, I forgot how pigmented this is. I haven't used this palette in a long time, so I'm glad I actually picked it because I really wanted to play. I've been eyeballing it to play around with it, and it's actually, it's just super, super pretty. I forgot how pigmented this was. This is such a good palette, though. And I love, like, the packaging. Like, how cool is that? Like, that's awesome, you know? Tarte does make... I feel like Tarte's hit and miss with their stuff. Especially, like, their limited edition, like, holiday palettes and things. There's one that I use all the time. It's the Aspen Ovard collab palette that she did. I think Aspen Ovard, I'm pretty sure she's a YouTuber. Either our social media influence or something like that. But anyway, she did a palette with Tarte, and I'm obsessed with it. It's a nine pan blush and highlight palette. And I got I actually got the one that I'm using, and then I bought two more because I didn't want it to, like, it was my favorite ever to, like, travel with too. But I gave one to my sister-in-law because it definitely, like, suited. She's very fair, and it definitely, like, suited her skin tone. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I, like, this would be so, like, good for her. So I asked if she wanted it, and she was like, oh yeah. So I have a backup, and then I'm still currently using the one. So I have a spare when it goes out, but I'm glad my sister-in-law got to get it and get use out of it. So nice. I like that. That's a really nice shadow. So there's that. I think I'm going to go in with, get a more pointy brush, clean her off. I think I want to go in with, we'll go in with Sure Thing, which is kind of this more like mauve-y tone. We're going to go that for more the inner inset right here of the crease. Kind of just deepen it up just a smidge. Alexa, next. Just changing the song. Oh, that's a good song. I know you probably can't hear it, but there we go. I just deepened up the crease just a little bit more. And I never, like, right here, you guys, on the inner part of the eye, I never, like, worry about if I get that sloppy, because usually the shimmer that I cover it up with is going to kind of mask that, and then I'll blend. It all just works out in the end. So I never really worry about getting kind of sloppy in here. I do worry about, though, this at the top is pretty blended. So now that I've looked at that again, I'm going to give that a little bit more of a blend at the top. Okay. Alexa, next. Not the kind of songs I want to hear right now. I don't know if y'all can hear that one, but Alexa, next. That's a good one. Okay. So now I'm going to grab a packer brush for the outside. Give her a little of a swirl. Sorry, that last brush with the red handle. This is a Smashbox. This is just the this shadow blending brush. It's just a little tapered pointy brush, which I find really good for, like, detail work towards in the inner corner, or not inner corner, but just the middle part of the crease. And this is just a Morphe packer brush, and it is the R39. And I'm gonna take the shade Shipwreck right here, which is this really pretty purpley kind of red deep tone. I'm gonna pack this lightly on the outer corner. I don't want to go too heavy on the outer corner, but I do want to give it a little bit more depth out here. So I'm just going to pack that, pack and start blending. Blends out so well. Definitely forgot about this palette. Alrighty. I don't know what shimmer I'm going to use, though, because there's so many pretty shimmers in this palette. Okay, so now that I've got that laid down and I'm pretty happy with that, I'm gonna kind of blend a little bit more towards, take it on the outside here and blending it up into the crease. I'm gonna kind of define that. Actually, I'm gonna take this a little bit deeper. Yeah, take it a little bit deeper. Yeah. Take it just a bit. Wasn't quite deep enough just yet for me. But now I'm confident and happy with that level of depth. Okay, so now I've got that laid down, I think it looks pretty good. Now, which shimmer? I don't even know where to begin. I could go more of a taupey, but let's see. We've got nude beach, frosé, I think it is, mimosa, and salt water. Let's see which one we like. Let's see. I'm swapping on my hand, and then you guys can help me pick it out. Let's see. These are all super pretty. Okay. So we've got, let's see. Oh, they're all so pretty. I think I'm actually gonna put frosé, that kind of pinky one, on the center. I'm gonna put this one towards the outer corner and then this one on the inner corner. We're gonna try that. We'll give it a whirl. And I do like to use my fingers when I do this because I feel like I have more control and I get better pigment payoff when I do use my fingers. So we're gonna take salt water, which is that deeper tone, and we're going to kind of just towards the outer corner here. That's so pretty. That is super pretty. You love that. Okay, tap that on just towards the outer corner. That's so pretty. Okay, so there's that. And then we're going to take Frosé, which is that kind of pinky, that second shade right there that was on our hand. We're going to take that in the center of the lid. Oh my gosh. Oh, I forgot how good this palette was. That's so pretty. That is so stinking pretty. We're going to take that over the majority of the eye surface area, the center. Bring that a little bit on this side. That's very pretty. Okay. So I'm going to take Nude Beach, that inner one right here, and try to pack her towards the center. Not center, the inner corner, excuse me. I'm gonna use a brush here in a second to really get into the inner corner there. I'm not flipping you off, I promise. I'm so sorry. I feel like my middle finger has more control on applying shadows. I don't know why, but I promise you, I don't. I'm a good Christian girl. I don't flip people off. All right, so we're gonna use this little brush here. This is a Morphe M421, just a little packer. And I'm gonna bring this one towards the center. And actually, I think I want to spray the brush. It's going to give me more pigment payoff. So we're going to do that actually. Okay, get the shadow on both sides. Just a little bit of MAC 6 Plus on there. And this should, yep, give us that color payoff we're looking for. Yeah, look at that. Just brightens that up. That's really pretty. Okay, and then okay. And it's really pretty. I really like that actually. Okay. Tuck in a little bit more. I really want to make that inner corner pop when you're looking. I think it's pretty pretty. Pretty pretty. It's very pretty. Okay, that's pretty good. That eye boogie, ew. Okay, let's be honest. You know, YouTubers are like, they always edit that stuff out, and they're all just like, they see an eye boogie, and they like, just pick it, but they'll edit that part out. I ain't got time for editing here. Plus, I'm not that good at it, so you see all my flaws. But that's okay, right? It's real. And so I'm going back over now with that outside shade that we used, and I'm going to just kind of blend that in a little bit more so it doesn't really have those harsh lines on the outer portion. Go back in with our more precise brush back into the crease with no extra product on, just what was left, and just kind of clean that up a bit. So as you can see, it makes everything look really smooth. And actually, I'm gonna go back in with Frosé and tap right here close to the lash line, because I have hooded lids and sometimes it doesn't look like the color gets all the way close to the lash line for me. Okay, that's a little better. Okay, that is better. So I'm just going back in, clean it up a bit. Okay. I think that's pretty cute. I really like that. What do you guys think? was pretty cute. Okay. So the liner that my baby picked out is a really old one. This is by the brand Ico. It just says Ico eyeliner. And yeah, this is super old. I think I got this in like a Ipsy, like way back when, but this has a brush tip on it. I do love brush tip liquid liners. This one lasts really well, so I'm actually really glad that he picked this one out. So I'm gonna go in. I'm just gonna get a mirror up close so I can actually see what I'm doing. I'm just gonna get as tight to the lash line as possible. Starting to get a little dry. I don't know how it's lasted this long, if I'm being completely honest. Let's see. Doing pretty well so far. Got more ink in it than I remembered it having. Of course, I do have a bunch of liners open, so it could just be me, but it's pretty good. I'll make that a little more even there. Okay. I don't know why, but like it's hard for me to talk when I'm doing eyeliner because I feel like I really have to concentrate. Otherwise, it's not gonna go well. I don't know why, but it's not really wanting to come off now. What is going on with you? Don't tell me you're gonna choose now to run out. Seriously. Okay, this is like not wanting to come off now. I don't know what's going on. I'm gonna try to make this work. I love how I just held that right up in front of you. I feel like that actually helped a bit. Come on. Last a little bit longer. It's as good as we're gonna get with that liner. This needs to be thrown away. Okay. All right. So there is that. And the last two steps he picked out for me were my mascara and my lip. But actually, I'm gonna spray first. So I always spray my face first before I do my mascara because I don't want to transfer. So I think I'm gonna just actually almost we'll do this one. The L'Oreal. This is the Lumi Shake and Glow spray. I really like this spray. It's got a little bit of oil in it, so it makes it kind of dewy. Really fine mist. It smells delicious. Let's kind of fan that. Make sure it stays down. Let me go back in with my sponge and just kind of get any bigger droplet places. Look at that pretty glow it gives to the skin. I really love that. I'm going to get a couple squirts of the Tatcha. Okay. That should make her really glowy. Woo! Yes. Okay. So the mascara that you picked out was the Too Faced Better Than Sex Waterproof Mascara. When I first got this, I don't know if it was just me. Let me know if anybody else had this experience. But the Too Faced Mascara was kind of dry, like, when I first got it. And I don't know if it's just me, but I don't know. I feel like it shouldn't be that dry. But maybe it's just the formula because it's waterproof. Although I've owned quite a bit of waterproof mascaras because it's just usually what I use. And I don't ever recall them being that dry. So I'm just going to go ahead and do this really quick. I do like this. It does get that volumizing, but still kind of separating out towards the end. Yeah, actually, I need to use this more, but I just feel like it's just so dry. It looks nice in the lashes, but I feel like it's so dry. Let me see. I just don't know how I feel about it, but it's not bad. Well, the real question is, do I want to do this lashes. Straight away. I think I'm gonna do this in the bottom lashes. Let me get up close and personal again. Oh, it's the tongue. Whenever I do that, with the tongue, hold it that way, you mascara. It's really pretty on the bottom lashes, though. I need a light. There it is. Come on. Cute. Okay. And then for the final, every time I always do my face, my nose gets itchy and I don't know what it is. All right, for the final step, he picked out this. It's the Marc Jacobs. Oh my gosh, my nose. This is the Marc Jacobs Enamored Hydrating Lip Gloss Stick in the shade 552 Mocha Chocolata, which is one of my favorites. I love this. It's just a twisty up stick, which you can't twist back down, by the way. So if you ever get these, can't twist them back down. But it's a hydrating lip tint, and it is gorgeous. Uh-huh. It's really pretty. Did I get that even? I hope so. Pretty. It's one of my favorite colors. I look, it's just so easy and effortless to apply. So yeah. That is pretty much it. Pull my hair back down. And put purple shampoo in it. Okay, so that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. So yeah, we're gonna throw the hat back on because my hair is super bad. But anyway, so that is the final look. I think he actually did really well picking everything out. Actually, I'm just gonna throw my hair up, so give me 2 seconds while I put it up in a messy bun. You never wanna know how I do this. I just pull up in a high ponytail like that, right? And then you grip it, and you're going to pull it through, and then grab it with the other hand, and then pull your ponytail once, twice. You're gonna take it and pull and fan it down, and that's how we get our sassy bun, in case anybody wanted to know. But anyways, yeah, that's the finished/final. There you go. I'm talking about my brain thinking a million miles faster than my mouth, but that's the final look. I think he did a good job picking stuff out, even so he says he doesn't know anything about makeup, but I think he did a good job just blindly picking. Either that, or I'm really good at picking out my own makeup, and so whatever I pick out, he couldn't go wrong with. Anyway. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know what you think down in the comments. And yeah, I'll be coming at you guys soon with a powder declutter, because I forgot to do my powders. I don't know how I forgot, but I forgot to do my powders. So I'll be doing a powder declutter and a skincare declutter, so that'll be fun. And then I have a book declutter coming, which I'm a huge bookie, so that's gonna be really fun. So yeah, I have a few more videos planned out for you guys, and then I also have a Shop My Stash coming up. So, I'm really excited. I'm cranking videos out. Like I said, I'm here at home in quarantine, so nothing to do but to do it. So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed. Stay safe. And yeah, I will see you all very, very soon. Bye!